Good morning, my dear students. Today we are going to start the poem If, which is written by Rudyard Kipling. So first let us talk about the poet. You can see here the picture of the poet, that is Rudyard Kipling. Rudyard Kipling, 1865-1936, was an English author. He was born in Mumbai in India. He was awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1904. He is the best known for his novels, The Jungle Book, The Second Jungle Book, Kim, and Captain Courageous. This was about the poet Rudyard Kipling. So let us see about the poem. If is the most famous poem and loved by people all over the world. If poem is an ultimate inspiration that tells us how to deal with different situations in life. The poet conveys his ideas about how to win this life and how to be a good human being. This poem was written in 1895 and it was first published in Rewards and Fairies in 1910. This is a 32 lines long poem. It has four stanzas. Each stanza has 8 lines. Now this poem is written in the form of paternal advice to the poet's son, John. It is a guideline on how to live and act with integrity and right values so that one can become an ideal human being. You see, we face many situations in life. So how we tackle all these situations, how we face these situations, and how to overcome and how to become a perfect human being. These guidelines are given by a father to his son in this poem, If. Now let's start the first stanza of this poem. If you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you. Now keep your head means to maintain our composure. That is to keep calm and be in our control when everything around us is falling apart. So in any situation we have to be calm, that is keep your head. It is an idiom. So if you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you. Now here the poet tells that to be a good human being and to succeed in life, you should keep calm when other people around you are losing their cool or losing their temper. You should not lose your temperament even if others are blaming you for their fault. Now many times it happens that other people around you, they blame you for their fault. It is not your fault, but still they blame you. So at that time, you should not lose your temper. Because losing the temper does not solve any problem. On the other hand, the problem becomes more intense or more complex. So if you keep your head cool, it will help you to think wisely and to face those tough situations, and you can come up with a solution. So even if there is any toughest situation, you should not lose your temper. If you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance for their doubting too. Now, make allowance for means consider what others have to say about something. So here the poet tells that you should have faith in yourself even when others doubt you. You should have faith in yourself. You should trust yourself even when others doubt you. But you should also give some importance to their doubt. You should consider what they have to say. And you should try to find out what is the reason for their suspicion. Because to err is human. Means after all, you are a human and you can also make mistake. So you should consider what they have to say. So if you keep faith in yourself, you make sure that you don't get demoralized. And if you allow others doubt, if you consider their doubt, then you can ensure that you are not doing anything wrong. Let's move ahead. If you can wait and not be tired by waiting. Here, the poet wants to say that you should have patience. You should wait for the things to happen. And you should not get tired by waiting. So in your life, you should work hard and you have to wait patiently for the results. Many people, they miss the big opportunities because they lose their patience. They don't have patience. So here the poet wants to say that you should have patience and you should not be tired of waiting. Because, see, if you don't have patience or if you hurry, then hurry will bury you. So you should not make haste of anything because haste makes waste. Or being lied about, don't deal in lies. Or being lied about. Here, the phrase means false things spoken about oneself. There may be certain time when people may lie about you to others. But you should not involve yourself in lies. You should always remain truthful. In your classroom also, many times your friends tell lie about you. Even when you have not spoken any lie, but they tell lie about you. So in such time, You should not speak lie. You should be always truthful. If we lie, one or the other day people may come to know about it. They will find out the truth and then they will not believe you anymore. So it is important to speak the truth every time. Or being hated, don't give way to hating. Now most of the time people may show hatred towards you. They may hate you. And at that time also you should not hate them. You should show your love and respect to others. Now see here, nobody is perfect in this world. Everyone has some strength and weaknesses. So you should accept that. And you should respect others for their good qualities in them. You should try to find out the good qualities and forget about the bad qualities. And you should respect them for their good qualities. You should not hate them. Okay. And yet don't look too good nor talk too wise. So here the poet wants to say that you should not show as you are a good person, or you should not talk wisely with common people. Even after having all these qualities, even if you have the above qualities, you should not think yourself good or talk wisely with common people. See, if you have these qualities, it is general that people feel proud and they tend to show off that how good they are. So the poet wants us that not to do that way, because other people may feel uncomfortable in your company if you always show off. Other people will feel uncomfortable and they will avoid you. And sometimes it may also happen that people may try to prove you wrong, and then it will harm you. Let us see the figures of speech used in this stanza. See the first line, if you can keep your head when all about you. So the sentence starts with if, or the clause starts with if. The second clause, that is the third line, it also starts with if. So when the clause or a line starts with the same word, it is called as anaphora. Anaphora means the repetition of a word or phrase at the beginning of the successive clauses. Next, there is assonance in the fourth stanza. But make allowance for their doubting too. So here you can see the word allowance and doubting. Allowance and doubting. Ow sound is repeated. So here the figure of speech is assonance. Ow, that is vowel sound. So when in between the words, whenever the vowel sound is repeated, then it is called as assonance. See the next line, if you can wait and not be tired by waiting. Here the figure of speech is imagery. Now what do you mean by imagery? Imagery means to use a figurative language to represent objects, actions and ideas in such a way that it appeals to our physical sense. Now in this line, if you can wait and not be tired by waiting, the reader feels as if she or he were being tired of waiting. That feeling comes to the reader, and that is what the writer of it wanted the readers to feel about. So when the reader feels it, or it creates an image in the mind, then it is called as imagery. So these are the figures of speech in the first stanza. Now let's start with second stanza. If you can dream and not make dreams your master. Now here the poet says that to do something bigger, you should dream first. But the poet also reminds you not to be guided by unrealistic dreams. If dreams become in charge, or if dreams try to control you, you would get distracted from reality and you would fail. So you should see dreams, but you should not allow them to control you. If you can think and not make thoughts your aim. If you can think and not make thoughts your aim. It means you should be able to think over matter. But you should not make thoughts your aim. Thoughts can be good or bad. So you should not make those thoughts your aim. Suppose if you make bad thoughts your aim, then it would be very harmful for you. You can lose your path, your way, and get distracted from the main point. So your thinking should not be scattered, misleading you away from the target. It should not mislead you from your target. So you should not make thoughts your aim. If you can meet with triumph and disaster and treat those two imposters just the same. Now here, triumph means victory, or here you can call it as success, and disaster means failure. So whenever you come across success and failure, you should treat those two imposters. Now here the poet has called them as imposters, called triumph and disaster as imposters. Now what do you mean by imposters? Imposters means one who deceives other by pretending to be someone else. Now, you all know that life is a combination of success and failure, joy and sorrow, good times and bad times. So you should accept both and face both situations similarly. Here the poet personifies triumph and disaster by calling them imposters, that is, cheaters. People become too happy in success and forget their duty. Or you may also get too self-satisfied or proud at small victories, small successes. You may feel very proud, and that will reduce your chance to reach higher goals. Then during bad times, if you grieve too much, if you become very sad, you may lose your faith and confidence. So in both the cases, our regular work is hampered. That is why the poet calls triumph and disaster two imposters. So he tells to treat both these cheaters similarly with a smiling face. It means that don't be too happy or too sad under any circumstances. If you can bear to hear the truth you have spoken, twisted by knaves to make a trap for fools. Now, knaves means dishonest people. If you can bear to hear the truth you have spoken, twisted by knaves to make a trap for fools. Now, the poet says that you have to bear tough situations where you see that your statement is twisted or distorted or contorted by someone to befool others. Whatever truth you have spoken, that truth is twisted by the knaves, by the cheaters or dishonest people for their advantage and to make a trap for fools. So these dishonest people, they may use your truth by changing it for their own advantage. They can create a trap by it for the fools. So in such situation, you should not lose temper hearing that. You should tolerate it and ensure that you have spoken the truth. Or watch the things you gave your life to broken and stoop and build them up with worn out tools. Build apostrophe EM. It should be read as build them. Okay. Or watch the things you gave your life to broken and stoop and build up with worn out tools. Now, stoop means bend one's body forward and downwards, and worn out means old. So here the poet says that you have to hold your nerves even after seeing that your favorite thing that you build with all your efforts and time is broken. So your favorite thing which you have built with all the efforts, you have spent a lot of time in building that, and if such thing is broken, then too you have to hold your nerve, means you have to be calm. Then you have to pick up all the scattered parts and build it all over again. So if your favorite thing is broken, don't be sad. Gather everything and build it again. So this is the key to get to the top of the world. Now let us see the figures of speech used in this stanza. So see the first line. If you can dream and not make dreams your master. Here, the figure of speech used is personification. Now, what is personification? Personification is a figure of speech in which a thing, an idea, or an animal is given human attribute. A non-human object are portrayed in such a way that we feel they have the ability to act like human beings. So here, to become a master is a human quality, but here that quality is given to dream. So this is personification. Also, there is anaphora in this stanza too, because you can see the word starts with if. So there is anaphora. See the third line. If you can meet with triumph and disaster. If you can meet with triumph and disaster. Here also there is personification. Because here success is personified as triumph, and it can make us self-satisfied. Failure is personified as disaster. It can influence us to believe that failure is permanent. Now here also the word meet is used. Meet is always something to do with human activity, right? Human beings meet each other. But in this poem, the writer used this verb for non-human qualities. So here, the figure of speech is personification. So see, if you can meet with triumph and disaster and treat those imposters just the same. So in these lines, the figure of speech used is metaphor. Now here, imposters is actually a person who pretends to be someone else in order to cheat others. But here, triumph and disaster are compared or portrayed as imposters. Because when dealing with them in life, their coming is apparent, but very deceiving, that they may come and go in one's life. Next, and treat those two imposters just the same. So see the words, treat those two. T, t, t. The beginning sound is repeated. So it is called as alliteration. When the beginning sound is repeated in the line, it is called as alliteration. If you can bear to hear the truth you have spoken, twisted by knaves to make a trap for fools. Now see the words knaves and make. A sound is repeated in between the words. So when the vowel sound is repeated in between the words, the figure of speech is assonance. So in this line you can see assonance, because the word A is repeated in knaves and make. Or watch the things you gave your life to broken and stoop and build them up with worn out tools. Now build them up with worn out tools. Here the figure of speech used is imagery. It expresses the physical feeling, which makes the reader feel like stooping and building something. So here the readers play a role, just like a building constructor needing for much energy to build something. In the same line, metaphor is also used. Now here, worn out tools, they refer to the feeling of total exhaustion, tiredness, which can force someone to give up. So here the figure of speech used is metaphor. Also there is symbolism. Now here, twisted by knaves to make a trap for fools. Now here, the word knaves is used as a symbol. It represents scoundrels, liars, or common. So it is called as symbolism, if any word is used as a symbol. So here knaves is used as a symbol for scoundrel, liar. Okay, so the figure of speech is symbolism. That's it for today. We'll see the next two stanzas in another video. Thank you.